Sorry, guys, you know, just chopping off some peppers. Welcome back.
What are you feeling like?
I'm feeling youthful. So Moet is working her butt off.
Yes, sweating as well.
So what do we have in the pot so
far? Right now, I fried the onions with palm oil.
Can you use like a different type of oil, or does it have
to be?
Let's keep it.
You know, there's some food that shouldn't be messed with. Compliant.
Well, just trust me, palm oil is even like quite healthy. Yes, it is. So palm oil is a better one. Then I'm just gonna leave it just to like simmer for a bit.
Okay.
Because I chopped almost like all the okro. But what I normally do, if there was time, is I would chop half of it.
Okay.
And then
grate the other half.
I would, yes, grate or blend the other half. But I just put everything chopped up. So it's going to be a really lumpy soup.
Mm. I like chunky okra.
I hope you like onions too, because I cook with onions. Some people are really particular and they like to pick out onions.
Okay. No problem.
Alrighty. So there's an image that we're going to try to caption now. So
which
let's
is
check out
the picture of David Bowie and Iman.
Let's look at it again.
These two had like a lot of iconic images together.
Yeah.
I remember the one of them on the beach, and you know, they're running after each other.
You guys know a lot about these
David
two.
Bowie, and I'm obsessed. They're like perfect. You know,
they're such
love
opposites
for me. They are opposites, but they
never put them together. Like you know, they're just so unlikely. But it just seemed like
just
it worked.
Saw them together. They
do you think it
happy.
Worked though?
I think it did. I think it's really hard to. I mean, I know there's
celebrity. Because she was married, I think, twice before.
Oh, okay.
And then they
was he married or did he just have relationships? I don't know.
I'm not sure if he was married. But then they found each other and
yeah. I feel like every time I saw a magazine interview or like
some kind of thing
where they were either
other.
Together or yeah or they
separately,
were
yeah.
they would talk about each other. He would talk about her especially with such reverence. You know what I mean? Mm. You know, like when you just
kind of like how Kanye talks about Kim, even though you guys don't
Lord. What are we gonna do about you now?
You've got a Kim Ye fan in the house.
You know, well, that is true though.
He does talk about his
boo with reverence. But yeah, I mean, I like that. I mean, it's nice to see a man who really stands for his wife. You know what I mean? It's super like enthusiastic and like you know respectful about his wife, especially when. You know, it's a relationship that's probably people will already look at it crooked. One, she's African. You know, there's the interracial thing, and then there's the intercultural aspect as well. You know what I mean? So they'll be like, how did this one find this one? And what did they have in common? What are they talking about? But somehow or the other, they made it work.
Yeah.
You know. So.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what did you just put the shrimp in?
I just put the prawns. Yes.
What were they marinated?
Yes, they were marinated with. This is what. I guess I'm working with today, but most times they call it dry pepper if you go to the market.
Yeah, to the market. That's what I pick.
So yeah, so I'm gonna. I marinated that with some Noor, just a cube of Noor, and some garlic, as well as some white pepper.
Mm.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Okay.
So
nice.
Captioning the image, I'll just say, you know, look at them. Look at us.
Look at us. That's so a good cool. one. Let's let that.
Let it slide. Simmer.
Yeah, let's let it do its thing. All right. So now time for our African proverb. Our proverb of the day is we're really going with this Iman thing today. So
we are.
It's because it's from Somalia. So our proverb reads: a cat in her house has the teeth of a lion.
Yeah.
A cat in her house has the teeth of a lion.
You know when you think you're bad and you're indoors,
like when you're in your territory, you're the boss.
The moment you step out,
so that's from
meet
Somalia.
A real,
that's a proverb from Somalia.
The moment you meet a real, you know.
When you meet a real lion, you know that I'll wait till. This is not my real face. I'm just a cat. I'm not really a lion.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, there's something to be said for being comfortable in your own space and feeling. I feel like you should feel good about it. Like when you're in your domain and you know you're. I feel like, you know, you have the right to feel like a boss, but you do have to recognize that, okay, you're still in your own pond. When you get into the big old sea, you might not be.
Now, I have a question for you with the whole, like, entertainment scene and how every day there's a new VJ, there's a new TV presenter, whatever. How do you you know, mark your territory.
Would I mark my territory?
We're going to take a quick break, so we'll let you think about it.
Okay, cool. Thanks.
Yeah. So when we come back, we're going to be finding out how the lovely Moet marks her territory and lets you guys know that she's the big dog. We'll be right back.
Welcome back to The Spot. We've got Moet Abebe in the house cooking up a storm in the kitchen for us without Ebuka today. We are lucky. So it's time for us to, you know, get to know you a little bit better.
Yeah.
So the cook side of you.
Yes.
No, we were asking how she marks her territory.
Oh, yes, that's it.
Yes, you were. I feel like when it comes to marking your territory, especially for me, I feel if you are so confident in your own skin, no one will be able to take your position. Mm. Like if you're confident doing what you're doing, then that's what makes you different. Mm. Because yeah. I feel a lot of people who are in this industry are not as confident as it may seem. Mm. So I think my way is just to always just feel like I'm gonna kill it.
Yeah.
And yeah, that's it. How I deal with it, really.
Okay. Just how you do.
So we mentioned earlier that a lot of people don't know that you love to cook and you cook very well.
And you have a business.
And you have a catering company. When did that?
Yeah.
When did that start my business?
Yeah.
This year.
Okay.
Just pretty much about 2 months ago.
Okay.
My mom and I decided that, hey, why don't we do something? Because we both obviously love to cook.
Mm-hmm.
So why don't
and
we do something?
That's who you learned from?
Yeah, that's who I learned from, my mom. Yeah. My mom's an amazing, amazing cook. Yeah. I know everyone says their mom is good, but trust me. Like, my mom is really, really good at cooking. So, yeah, and it's always been like a passion of hers. And I felt my mom has tried a lot of businesses over the years that have worked, but not worked to its full potential. And I've always said that if we do something with food, because people love to eat.
Yeah.
So, and you're a good cook. So if we do something with food, yeah, we could make
you're
this
gonna
happen.
Kill it, yeah.
What's the name of the company?
LM Occasions. Okay. Apart from that, we're also like an events planning, like into events planning as well.
Okay.
So my mom like literally went all the way to America to study like how to sort out, you know, tables and where to put the napkin and flower arrangement, as well as also cooking like different sorts of meals. My mom can cook everything Indian, Chinese.
Oh.
I can't even do that. I can just pretty much cook Nigerian food.
Okay.
But yeah, so. Nice. My mom's like full on, she's ready.
She's ready for it. Oh, nice. So what's your favorite thing to cook?
I like rice, so jollof rice. Oh, I love to cook jollof rice, yeah. But then
do you jazz up your jollof rice?
Yes, I can. I would put like sweet corn, spring onions, anything you want.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes I can make it almost like into a jambalaya.
Yeah.
So I'll put sausages and stuff like that.
Nice, yeah.
That's you know, jollof rice with ginger. Kind of jollof rice you're happy to eat. Yes. Cool. So we've added the shrimp.
We've added the shrimp. We've added the prawns, which were all marinated before.
Mm-hmm.
We've added the catfish.
Okay. Can you use any other kind of fish, or is this just
it's
your preference?
Well, you can use any type of fish, but I like to use white fish.
Okay.
So catfish, croaker, those type of fish.
Okay. Cool. Nice. And in terms of like your business now, where you guys are trying to go, do you think that this is something, I mean, yes, tell us actually where it is you're trying to go. Like, you know, you've just started, so you're a few months in.
Yes.
So you're doing events and things now.
Mm-hmm.
What else is, you know, what else are you kind of looking forward to
doing? Another thing that we're also trying to work on is if we can get like a few clients who have staff.
Okay.
So if we're catering for people almost and on a daily basis. So if we have like set menus from Monday to Friday, and we also have maybe like two or three companies
that you service,
that we service. Okay. So that's also what we're also looking into doing.
That's a good one, because I don't know that a lot of people actually do that.
No.
Okay. That's pretty cool.
So is this the first thing that, because like, you know, now a lot of artists and musicians and TV presenters, or everybody's trying to diversify into something.
Yeah, I think everybody's a little bit using a little bit of their entrepreneur bone.
To find a leg in something. So it's interesting that you didn't go in the in a direction that's like related to your
business
field, like media or music. So like, for instance, Vijay Adams, who's also a VJ, went into, you know, creating music and becoming somewhat of an artist.
Well, I feel it's best for you to do something that you enjoy and you're actually good at. I can't sing to save my life. I can't rap, I can't do any of those things. So
you don't want to go into like management?
No, I want to be managed.
Okay.
Does that make sense? Like,
yeah,
I feel, like I feel.
You have a lot going on.
Exactly.
And you need
so
to,
I can't start managing someone else.
Okay.
No.
So,
like, okay. So cooking is something I love to do. I do it literally pretty much on a daily basis. So, yeah, why not do it and make money?
Yeah, fair enough. And we, as you said before, we all need to eat. Everybody
exactly.
needs to eat.
That's the one way. Like,
yeah.
Eating and drinking. And what else? Maybe partying. I think those are three, like, the easiest. When I say easy, not that it's easy to set up necessarily, but easiest things to kind of get into if you're good at it. So if you want to set up like a, I don't know, a club of some sort, and if you know that you know a lot of people, then obviously that would work.
Yeah.
If you want to set up a cooking company or a catering company, like my in my case, you have to obviously be good at cooking. If you want to set up whatever you want to set up, just make sure that you're good at it.
Or you get the right people.
People who are good
Who are good at it, yeah. Okay, I know you said, you know, your mom's sort of the, she's probably the, not the face of the business, but the like more hands-on
she's the
person
more
with all the planning and the, you know, the meticulous details and things like that. What are the things that you guys each do that get on each other's nerves with LM? What have you found that you've been like butting heads
LM? My mom constantly calls me like every day, oh, Mo, have you put up the picture on Instagram? I wish she doesn't know any of that stuff. So I'm pretty much in charge of social media.
Yeah.
And basically like getting, you know, being on shows like this and getting people aware of the fact that I've got this going on. I'm more of the face because I'm obviously out there. My mom's not gonna be taking pictures of the kitchen and things like that. But she, this is literally almost like a retirement plan for her. So she's taking this super seriously.
So she's like, don't fall my hand, Mo. Do not like, fall my hand.
She's really relying on me to, you know, kind of get the word out there. So
Okay, fair enough. Okay. That's pretty good. I feel like I was saying, I think, to her before we started that,
Is that Cameroon
pepper? Cameroon pepper, yes.
Ooh, Cameroon pepper is so my favorite.
It is amazing.
I love it.
It is. I put it in everything, and I've noticed that it always, even if you want to make something that is more continental, if you put it, it just gives it this African twist. So it's like my little secret ingredient.
Nice. Okay. So I was saying that if I were to work with my mom, I don't know. I'm even trying to think, because she's like, actually, you know, if you're working at something that you both really love and whatnot, then maybe you know, it would be something that would work out. But I just feel like we would butt heads a lot.
Moms
we're very
are hard
similar.
To exactly. Yeah. Moms are very hard to work with.
I think moms they're, can be difficult.
You know, sometimes they're pretty stuck in their ways.
Oh
yes.
So it's hard to bring them. For instance, you're talking about handling social media and you know, explaining to them that, mom, yes,
it's important.
It's important for us to have a Facebook because this is what it does. And she's like, what?
What's that?
Not doing people just use Facebook to chat. Like, how's how the hell is that gonna help me? Yeah. So, yeah, I can see how difficult that can
be. But yeah, it has been quite tough. But at the same time, I'm really close to my mom. And there's no decision that I make that I don't ask my mom. So
yeah,
it was kind of a walk in the park for me to do this with her, because there's absolutely no decision I've made that I don't think I've consulted with
her,
my mom.
Yeah. And you know, trust is really, really important in business.
Exactly.
And in a partnership. And there's no, like, how are you not going to trust your mama?
Like,
she's the one. If you were to trust nobody else, you could, you know, you definitely would be trusting your mom with stuff like that. So how's it all going so far?
It's going fine. I don't know
how spicy. More pepper.
Yes.
Like,
how spicy do you like your food?
Wait. I just want to say that.
I'm just going to put one more. You see, like, I don't know. When it comes to Nigerian soups, it needs to have that spice.
Fire.
Yeah. Or else.
You know, it's really nice when it's going in. When it's coming out, it's quite
nasty. Yeah.
You're like, whoa, that needs to put that much pepper in there.
But don't worry, it's not that much, trust me.
Okay, we're going to go on a quick break. When we come back, we have our topic of the day coming your way, so stick around for that.
Welcome back, guys. You are still watching The Spot. Zainab and I are here without Ibuka, but with the lovely Moet Abebe, and she is... making us some seafood okra. So yes. We've been watching that process, and we've gotten to know a little bit about her and what she does. Apart from being a VJ, she's also an entrepreneur. So she's the co-owner of LM Occasions, which is a catering company, mm-hmm. and they do lots of and event planning as well. Mm-hmm. So that's another side to her that we've learned about. But it's time for us to get into our topic of the day, which is food and health related, and it's skinny versus healthy.
Does it mean the same thing?
Yeah, does it mean the same thing?
No. Do they?
You know, people associate being healthy with being slimmer and so on.
Yeah.
Well, no, not to me. Skinny isn't the same as health.
So what does skinny mean to you? What
skinny
does it represent?
Skinny is thick, thin, like, you know, well, for a woman, let's say, yeah?
Yeah. So skinny even for a man, I think, because if you're, like, super, like, dry.
Yeah, like, just, you know, really, like, skinny to the bone, mm-hmm. nothing, no flesh. Mm-hmm. You've pretty much starved yourself, or maybe genetically or like that, I don't know, but you literally have no flesh, no meat, no jiggle, nothing.
She said no jiggle, and then she smiled. Okay, you see, that's the thing, is that, you know, you need a little jiggle in your life.
Yes.
You know, you can't just be like out here looking like bones with small skin stretched over.
And for me, there's a difference between skinny and slim.
Yeah.
So slim, I believe, has a bit more meat.
Yeah.
Still kind of slender. But not as, you know, far gone.
Not looking
at yes. Not looking gone.
You know, there's also slim thick, which is you're slim, but you've got curves.
Yeah.
Slim thick.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, I've heard slim thick. Oh, yeah. Like Kelly Rowland is slim thick.
Yes.
Rihanna is slim thick. Do you think Rihanna is slim thick? I think
I would say is slim thick for me would be maybe Khloe Kardashian.
Oh, but her thickness is she.
Yeah, we all know that it's like
she bought it.
She
bought it.
Yes, she bought it. Okay, let me think of someone who probably didn't. Okay, Ashanti.
Yeah, that's a slim thick. She's got a great body.
Yeah, she has got.
So it's basically just being body. Like, you know, well, let me not use the word skinny, but just being like, you know, right fat
in the right place.
Yeah,
exactly.
Right.
It's, so. I always feel like it's so tragic when you see someone who's like super, super skinny and they have like a weird, I don't know. You know,
and they think they're fat. That's the worst.
That's what we call body dysmorphia.
Yeah.
So
like when you just do, you're a certain shape, but you're just so convinced that you're like completely overweight or oh my gosh, this looks so huge. Mm. I mean, you know. But I think usually this is where women have, I feel like it's mostly women, although I know that some men have like eating disorders or body dysmorphia as well, but I feel like it's usually women that get the brunt of that, like we're the ones that look in the mirror and everyone's like, you're looking so, take away,
you
know, whatever,
sick.
And you're like, oh, I'm so huge, have you seen my shoulders, and you're like, what?
I know, I feel like there's a lot of pressure, most especially when it comes to, you know, TV, magazines, just in the media, there's a lot of pressure. And this is why I like Kim and Kanye, or let me just say at least Kim. I feel like since she came into the scene, she has stood up for short girls like myself.
Okay.
She stood up for
thick girls
like myself.
Although she also bought some of hers.
Yes, she did buy that still. But I feel like at least she's giving the world like a different sort of body type to look at. Because most people, as at maybe 10 years ago, it wasn't even cool to have a booty.
Yeah.
But now everyone wants booty and wants a tiny waist. Do you know what I mean? So I feel like now they have, in a sense, kind of given people a different image as to what sexy is or what beauty is.
Yeah.
May I say that, you know, black women, black African American women and video models and so on have been doing that for a long time. It's just that, you know, Kim was able to, you know, she was in front.
Yes.
A lot of the time.
True.
But you were talking about, do we need to go on a break now?
No.
Okay. You were talking about the pressures, and I wanted to talk about the pressure within Nigeria and the burden on women and what she used to look like. On the one hand, you know, you have men who desire the thicker, bigger woman.
Yeah.
On the inside, and then, you know, the slimmer, skinnier kind is the one that you show, off with.
Okay, so how men, like, they want I want an African woman that I want to hold, I want something to hold. Mm-hmm. But then you see them, like, maybe they'll be out with, like, their side pieces or whatever,
and they're
like, there's a real thin, tall, with a, you know, big, like, what is that about? Like, have you ever seen, like, what do you think about that, though, when you
I
see
just
things
feel
like
men
that?
Are just sometimes too greedy.
Yeah, they want everything.
That's just really, they just want everything. And in all honesty, you know, in the world, there are more women than men. I feel men have a really tough time, and I'm not giving mm-hmm, them, mm-hmm, you know, the benefit of the doubt.
Yeah. Yeah.
But they're even with me, we look different.
Yeah.
But our bodies are different. Your hair is short, my hair. So I feel like as a guy, if I was a guy, I would be so confused. I wouldn't know what to pick.
Which one?
I would be confused. So I kind of understand.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, it's just what society is, I guess.
Yeah.
And
This is a good question, actually, for us to think about body shaming. If,
yes.
You know, the way.
Have I ever been body shamed? Oh, too many times.
Yeah. Well, we'll talk a little bit more about that when we come back after this break, guys. Hey guys, welcome back. You're still watching The Spot. So we're talking skinny versus healthy with Moet Abebe. Remember that you can join in on the conversation via Twitter, Facebook. You can send us an email, Snapchat, Instagram. We're all over the place.
Nudes, whatever you want.
What?
What?
What did you say?
Hmm?
Did you say?
I said nudes.
Nudes? You're
whatever
a mess.
You want.
You're such a mess. Do not send any nudes, please. I'm not even trying to see you like that. I don't want to know you like that. Mm. Love you though. From
except your flavor though.
I'm sure he would
have. Do you have an industry crush?
Do I have an industry crush? No, actually, I don't.
No.
You don't?
So flavors.
You do.
I used to, but then I felt like it was fake anyway.
Boy band.
Yeah. Once upon a time.
Yeah.
Now I'm
so
over.
Apart from flavor, just flavor. Just flavor. Flavor. She said,
just like his body.
She went. I mean, he sure does help that image out with going everywhere shirtless.
So, yeah.
I mean,
I have seen grown mothers literally grow.
My mom.
Flavor.
My mom is a major
flavor.
I love you, mom. I really do love you. But she's a major flavor groupie. She loves
what?
Him. She loves
that's
him.
They literally clawed at him. I'm just like, your child is sitting over there.
Like, yeah, we don't care. We love you.
Okay, well, before the break, we were talking about body shaming.
Yeah.
So we could just share maybe a couple of experiences.
Some stories.
Like, I know you were like, have I been? Yes. But what for? Like, what
many
is it
things.
They say?
Many things. Oh, they.
I mean, not exactly. Like, what's their complaint?
A lot. Uh-huh. The first one is my height. I don't like. There's nothing that can be done about my height. I am short. Well, I like to call myself vertically challenged, but nonetheless, I feel it's not a big deal. I can't change my height, and I'm a girl. I can be short. It's okay.
Yeah, it's cute.
Exactly. Yeah. Mm-hmm. But apart from that, I've been called fat.
Really?
Yes. Oh gosh, too many times. I've been called fat. I've been called like certain parts of my body have been like, you know, pointed at,
okay.
Especially my legs, which I don't care about because my legs will always be thick. Even if I lose all the weight, trust me, these babies won't go down. So it doesn't really bother me as much as it used to, especially when I moved back from England, because when people were like, oh, this new girl, this new VJ on TV, and then, you know, people always try and find something that they can, you know, use to make you feel bad.
Yeah.
Exactly. But
yeah,
now I'm over it.
Okay. Over it. Okay. How about
you? So what about you?
So mine is that they think I'm too skinny. Like they look at me and they think depth. Like I'm gauntly.
Ugh.
So
I
like wearing off the shoulder like dresses and stuff. And clavicles are clavicles.
Yeah.
So they'll see like bone or maybe like, I'm like, the bone here, you're supposed to be able to see it like sometimes.
Yeah.
And they're like, no, this is not nice.
Wow.
So tuck it away. Or, you know, you go on holiday and you wear a swimsuit and they're like, why are you showing so much skin?
Oh, come on.
I'm
wait. You know, that's happened to me too many times. Like, I'm always like, am I supposed to wear a rambo bound?
Like, to the beach, can you imagine?
Yeah. Like, oh, it's too revealing.
Yes, that should be ready.
Yeah. You're really boring with your hair. You know, you should fix a weave. You should fix something.
But this is what I know you for, though. I can't even imagine what you... I can't imagine you with a weave.
Like, just leave me be. Okay? So they always have something. Yeah?
Does it look ready?
Yeah. Looks ready.
What about you? Let me do.
Looks ready. I usually get, you know, oh, you're really skinny and... Actually, that's just it. I just get, oh, you're just so skinny. And yeah, I have the clavicle thing as well. Always had, you know, the...
Can we swap? So they can call you fat sometimes. I would like to be called skinny.
And I just think, well, I mean, it's genetic anyway. Yeah. You know, both my parents are actually quite tall and quite slim. So I was never going to be a like, that's just the shape that I, you know, I have a very quick metabolism. So even when I eat a lot, you know, it kind of burns off kind of quickly.
Can we swap? Anyway.
Listen, once, no, after like 27 or 28, that metabolism starts going downhill. It starts slowing down. You're like, wait, what is, what's happening? You know, now I have to be careful. But I mean, I think that it's funny when Nigerians, because with the African culture thing, oh, you know, African women should be more, you know, curvaceous and whatnot. I get the, what's the Yoruba when you say, leron leti, which means like you don't have, it literally means you don't have meat in your ears. Like you don't, you're very, very thin, you're very skinny. So I get that. But I'm like, well, I look nice in the pencil dress. So if you like, die.
Exactly. You don't have a pot belly.
I like it. So. And I haven't had any complaints. The people that are looking for me, they're looking for me. The people that are not looking for me,
they can move over to the left.
Yeah, as somebody, one of my friends says, you know, I don't have to be your cup of tea, but that's why there's many flavors.
Nice.
You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, yes, no. So.
And the funny thing is that no matter what, someone out there, especially,
is looking for your specifications.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. So. Exactly for you. I'm trying to. Okay.
Okay.
Here we go. I want to.
So have you ever had? So in terms of like relationships now, if you've ever had a guy that you know wanted you to fit into a specific image-wise.
No. No? No, most of the guys I've dated have been more than happy with my body.
Okay.
So, yeah, I've never had that issue. Never.
Lucky you.
So, what you've had that issue?
I think...
Will you tell us after the break?
Okay.
Yes, we have to put Zainab on pause for just a little bit. When we come back, we're going to be dishing out the food and dishing out some secrets, I guess. So, please stay with us.
Hi spotters, please do continue to join us on Facebook, Twitter, and via email. We've been having a good time with Moet Abebe in the house, and the food is ready. The seafood okra is about to go round.
Yeah.
And we've been talking about skinny versus healthy. And earlier on you asked the question, no, or I asked a question about whether or not if you've ever had somebody in a relationship try to get you to fit into,
maybe change your image
a little bit. I think I've been, in one where, you know, the person felt like I would have been a bit more desirable if I had more weight on me.
Mm-hmm.
So and I didn't feel like I was losing weight. You know, I felt like I was in a good place.
Yeah.
However, for them, it just looked, healthier.
Yeah, for them.
For them.
Yeah.
Notice you said for them.
Yeah, I went. There was a guy I liked. We never dated because clearly I have sense. So, who said, I think you look, I mean, you're beautiful, but I think you'd look like so much better if you like lost a couple pounds.
Still?
Yeah.
What?
So that's how you know some people are not, they're not okay here. Because I was like,
I think you'd look more beautiful.
Maybe I'm trying to, like, I'm trying not to look like I'm a starving African child. You don't want me to look more like... I was like, if that's what you want, please,
go
and find... But this one here, I lose no weight. Thank you for that.
But I must say that I admire the brand new... Like, this new health kick that Nigerians have gotten themselves on. Mm. Fit Fam is really strong.
Yeah.
Everybody's out at the gym,
yes,
trying to find new ways to spice up traditional food and making it more healthy. We're jogging on the bridges, like... I like it, and it's, you know, it's trans. Thank you.
You're
it's
welcome.
It's trickling down to our parents. So you're seeing, you know, them take their health a bit more seriously.
Yeah. They're like not jogging. They're walking briskly to places, and you know, doing their stretches and stuff like that. They realize that, you know, health is definitely wealth.
Right?
How are you feeling? Let me do the taste test.
I'm feeling healthy.
You're feeling healthy?
And this is quite healthy, though.
It is.
Because it's a lot of fish.
Yeah, seafood is so healthy.
Exactly.
You can add a lot more vegetables and stuff to it,
yes,
if you want, right?
Yes. The okra that I used wasn't as much as I would normally use. But
this is really nice.
And you can have it by yourself.
I'm like, just saying that.
No, like
seriously. But I love seafood okro, with amala.
And you don't have to have it with swallow. You can
I can eat this on its own without anything.
Usually what will happen is I will get, like, when I make a lot, if I make it or I buy it or whatever, if I have it with, if there's swallow, I'll have like half swallow.
Yeah.
And then I'll just eat the rest. On its own, I like it anyway. It's just so rich. Like, it's full of stuff. It's not empty okro. You know what I mean?
What I think would be really nice with this as well? I just thought about Caribbean soup, dumpling.
Oh yeah, and dumplings are really good.
Mm. Never had that.
They sell dumplings here.
Can make it.
Oh, what do you make it with?
Flour. Nice. It's literally like
it's not fried though, right?
It's not fried. Okay. No. It's flour, something, and like maybe about 4 to 5 ingredients. You literally just roll it up and you drop it in the soup.
It really reminds me of plantain.
You know what? That's a, like a Nigerian.
Nobody should steal our ideas. Okay,
don't steal dumplings with seafood okra or like a sauce, some kind
and
of sauce,
and it will be healthy.
Very healthy
for those people out there who are team fit fam.
Yeah. So there's another aspect of skinny and healthy. That's another thing I actually wanted to talk about. How people think that automatically, if you don't have a lot of flesh on you, then that means you must be extremely healthy. But there are skinny people who are extremely unhealthy. Like, if I run up and down a flight of stairs, I'm probably going to be semi out of breath. I'm not very fit. You'd be all the way out of breath. There are people who are healthy who are skinny, who have extremely high blood pressure, who have extremely unhealthy lifestyles. Yes. Sometimes the reason they're skinny is because there's a lot of stress in their life. Sometimes maybe because they smoke, and that's one of the things that, you know, it's like an appetite inhibitor. Mm-hmm. So it, you know, keeps the weight off, or they don't eat a lot. So there's that myth about, oh, you know, if you're skinny, automatically you must be happy and healthy because everything looks good on you, everything fits you and everything. But inside, your body's not working, you know, as it should.
Quite as well.
So that's another aspect to it that I think people need to realize. And I've had to tell people, I'm like, don't, just because someone is skinny. And if you're skinny, it doesn't mean everything is six-pack. You can be skinny and flabby. Have you heard of skinny fats?
Yes.
Skinny fats.
Have you seen some skinny girls that have cellulite as well?
Yeah.
Cellulite is just
a
way of life.
But I think cellulite is normal. I have a lot of cellulite.
The black girl thing is always on the hips. You can't get away from it.
But you'll just be so surprised that you would see a girl who is clearly anorexic or has some sort of eating disorder, and she actually still has cellulite. So I just feel like take it so seriously, you know, even skinny girls have it. So.
What I love about the cellulite thing is that now there's
what you love about it.
There's this movement of people appreciating women with
cellulite.
With cellulite and their tiger marks, quote unquote.
Yeah.
And I see a lot of pictures on Instagram, you know, even with new moms just saying, look, I've just popped out a human being.
Yeah.
My body is still sexy. So there's no way that you can shame me.
What do you think about that? Because there's that thing too, right? That whole, you have to snap back immediately. Like for moms. Mm. And like, I feel sorry for celebrity moms. Mm-hmm. I really, really do. Because it must be extremely hard for you to give birth. And like in a week, you have to look like this again. Like, that's
I feel I'm just always going to be someone that won't, like, society cannot pressurize me to do what I don't want to do. Do you know what I mean?
Mm.
I feel I'm going to, if when I do get pregnant and I have my baby, my first child, let's say, I will
take the time you need.
Yeah, exactly. Take my time, you know, and do it the right way.
That's one thing I can give Kim, you know, kudos for, is that the second time around, she said, you know, it hasn't been easy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And as much as I've wanted to snap back and, you know, I've watched Chloe do it really fast, but I'm not going to look how I used to look. Mm-hmm. But I'm happy with the progress that I'm making.
Yeah. I actually remember with Courtney, when I watched the show.
She snapped.
What? But remember the second kid, that's her daughter.
Penelope.
Yeah.
She was, she had a photo shoot 2 or 3 weeks after the birth. So she was running 2 or 3 times a day, or she was running twice a day and then a workout in the middle of the day. So she would run in the morning, run at night. In the middle, she would do like maybe weights or whatever. And so she was doing all of that while at the same time trying to breastfeed or pump and all that kind of stuff. And at some point she fainted on a beach somewhere and they had to get an ambulance to take her. I remember watching like that episode and I just thought to myself, but look at what you're doing. That is the most
unhealthy
way to,
you know, you're gonna kill yourself, you know what I mean, just for the sake of, oh, I need to look skinny. So in that sense, I definitely do feel sorry for people who have more of a spotlight on them, mm-hmm. because there's that expectation of the way you need to look, mm-hmm. and once you look that way, you can never not look that way. Yeah, but it looks like it's time for us to take yet another break. Let's chow down some more and really focus on this delicious seafood. We'll see you in just a moment, guys.
Do you know what this is? This is the face of somebody who is very, very happy with their meal.
And I'm so glad I made you happy.
Yeah. You did.
Yes. Once
welcome back
this
to
one,
the
she's
spot,
happy.
Guys. It's almost time for us to go. But I thought that, you know, it'd be good for us to find a way to end on a good note. Mm-hmm. And any kind of, like, things that have helped you become happy with your body. Mm. I know that it's hard as you grow older or you go through things to accept the changes, and, you know, we haven't even experienced half of the things that are gonna happen.
Yeah.
So how have you come to terms with just loving what you see, mm-hmm. you know, having some bad days and so on, but...
Oh, yeah.
What I always tell myself, if I was to answer that, is no one can be a better you
than you.
So if you have an issue with yourself, the only person that's going to be able to fix that issue
is you.
Is mm-hmm. you. Mm-hmm. So if you feel bad, if you feel fat, if someone called you names because of how your body looks, that's just, it's you. Mm-hmm. That's what makes you unique. That's mm. what, so I don't see why you should really stress over what other people are saying about
right.
your body.
Yeah. Yeah. I like
to
that.
To add to that, mm-hmm. for people who do want to make changes, and changes aren't going to come with you, you know, just sitting on your ass.
Exactly. You got to put in work. Something. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Like, having a strict fitness regime, going mm-hmm. to the gym, it's not easy. Like, you look yeah. at these people on Instagram who make it seem
like it's like super, it's just you have to motivate yourself. It's
you
not
do.
Easy at
mm-hmm.
all. It's never easy, yeah. I'd say for me, just coming to terms with the things that I don't like, it's sometimes understanding that, yes, there actually are going to be days where you just don't like
what you see.
You mm-hmm. don't like your legs today yes. because, oh gosh, I can't fit in this pair of jeans today, whatever. And just recognize that, okay, you know what? Fine, not today, but maybe tomorrow. Mm-hmm. And also just being, we're not kind to ourselves a lot of times. Mm-hmm. Like, we don't think about ourselves as people who we need to care for. Mm. There needs to be a level of self-care that's automatic. Like, I don't think we should work up to pampering ourselves or giving ourselves a day off for mm-hmm. being like, you know what, actually, well, these thick thighs look hella good in some, you know, in some skinny jeans, so. Mm-hmm. I feel like we should automatically say, okay, you know what? Maybe today's a bad day, but I'm going to appreciate the fact that these thick legs can get me from here to there. Some people don't have
exactly.
legs to get me from here,
exactly.
you know, from here to there. Some people
exactly.
don't have arms or they don't have mm-hmm. eyes. So you just think of the utility of what mm-hmm. it is that you don't appreciate and be like, you know what? Somebody else doesn't have that.
Exactly.
And I have it. So, you know, appreciate. Thank you. Appreciate
oh, thank
what it
you.
Is that that you have and, you know, just be thankful. And also sometimes, you know, sometimes if you have good friends and good people around you too, you know, you'd be like, oh.
Yeah, where you get like positive energy and
yeah,
positive vibes.
You know,
so you
be
feel
around
better about
the
yourself.
Right kind of people. Because, you know, there are people who have frenemies
yes.
that be like, ah,
yeah, you do
you
look
fat. Like,
yes.
and you know what I'm saying?
No,
like, how can I say, oh,
you.
How does my booty look? Like, she knows if I say, how does my booty look in these jeans? She knows how to answer. Mm-hmm. Because she's my friend. She knows how I want it. It might not look that way for real, but she's going to tell me that it does because she knows I might need a boost today. You know
yeah.
what I mean? So have people around you that don't bring you down,
yeah.
you know, and don't prey on your insecurities or whatever. So
who's your celebrity body crush?
People I have a lot.
Oh, yeah, name like two or three.
Two or three.
Apart from Kim.
You know what? I don't even really like Kim's body.
Okay.
Yeah. Ashanti.
Mm-hmm.
Who else again? In Nigeria, or let's say in Africa.
Yeah.
I really like Victoria Kimani's body.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. She's
again?
A sweet person, too.
And she's really sweet, yeah. Mm-hmm. You see, with some people, they have certain aspects to them I like.
That you like.
So maybe
right.
I like someone's legs, or I like someone's
okay.
arms,
yeah.
or I like someone's shoulders. Like, I love Rihanna's body, but mm-hmm. I loved her body more when she was a lot fuller.
Okay.
I feel like she's actually lost weight over the years,
mm-hmm.
yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So I liked her when she was fuller. But one thing I love about Rihanna's body, I love her shoulders. They're just perfect.
Mm-hmm.
And her arms, and yeah. So yeah, I would say Rihanna, mm-hmm. Ashanti. And if we were to talk in Africa, I'd say Victoria Kimani.
Okay,
yeah.
cool. You?
I like Shay Shay's body.
Okay.
She's like not slender. She's not super fit, mm-hmm. but she looks good. Mm-hmm. Internationally, I love thick Beyonce.
Mm. She said thick Beyonce. Okay.
Mm. She just looks so good. Who else? Yeah. Those are the people that I can think of. I know who yours is.
Kelly Rowland and Ciara.
Oh, yeah.
Honey, Sierra's like...
Someone should just remove their... No one should remove their heads. But, like, if I could wake up and look like either of those two ladies, oh, I would never be humble a day in my life.
Can I add one more person?
Yes.
Serena Williams, but not her arms. I don't like her arms, I like her body. It's amazing. It's so nice how she's so athletic, but at the same time...
Still feminine.
She's womanly. Still really curvy and feminine.
Right.
Yeah,
it's a good one. All right, guys, looks like it's time for us to go. We've run out of time. We're still digging into our food. Thank you so much, Moet, for coming and making us a delicious meal.
Thank you for having me.
Ebuka, I'd like to say that you were missed, but you weren't. There was more food to go around. But thank you guys for watching. We'll see you next time.
Bye.
Bye.
Oh, I could go to sleep happily now.
I know. I actually have to drive.